How do you know when you're healthy? You certainly know when you're sick. That's when you don't feel good. And a lot of times you seek out care in a doctor's office because you don't feel good. You know that you're sick. But the likelihood is that you were probably sick for a long time before you had your first symptom. The average person who has cancer has the disease for 7 years before it becomes symptomatically evident. So think about that. A person has cancer in their body, cancer cells that are developing for 7 years before it even becomes diagnosable, before they know that you have cancer, before you can feel that you have cancer. Think about heart disease, number one killer in the United States right now. A person has heart disease for months, if not years, before they have their first symptom of angina or a heart attack. Think about a person who has a subluxation, a misalignment in their spine that's causing stress to the nervous system. Generally, I find by looking at x-rays and looking at other tools that we measure subluxation, the average person has subluxation for months, if not years, before it's diagnosed in my office. So this concept of thinking about health in terms of physiology instead of symptomatology is really worth talking about. So let's dig a little deeper. You know, in our office, we do something called a wellness score, which your doctor may want to do. And looking at a wellness score is not looking at what symptoms you're having. It's looking at how your body is functioning. So certain things that a doctor may want to do is looking at your blood pressure, looking at how your body is moving through a functional movement screen. Can you squat? Can you move your arms and shoulders? Can you move your spine? You have 53 joints in your spine that are designed to move. So how well are those joints moving? Looking at other things like your body composition and your BMI. Any BMI over 30 is considered obese in this country. It's considered obese all over the world. But it's interesting to note that 2/3 of our population has a BMI over 25, which puts them overweight. And 1/3 of our population has a BMI over 30, which puts them obese. Now, most people kind of know when they look in the mirror, but they don't specifically know what their number is. And when we go to the doctor, we're so used to getting numbers to tell us whether we're healthy or not. So how about a number that's going to tell you whether you're moving towards chronic disease and illness or whether you're moving away from it? And by the way, you're always moving in one direction or another. So ask yourself, do I want to move more towards chronic disease and illness and sickness, or do I want to move more towards optimal health and well-being? And obviously that's a very easy question to answer. You want to move more towards optimal health. But the reality is most people are moving away from it because of the way that they're living their lifestyle. And what I've found in my office is that people don't make decisions based on logic. Because if they did, no one would smoke, everyone would be getting adjusted, everyone would be eating organic good food, nobody would sit for 8 hours a day, everybody would be moving their body and exercising, but that's just not the reality of the situation. So why do we make certain decisions? We make it based on feeling, not logic. And so when you feel the effects of your physiology, when you're able to see a grade, we give all of our patients a grade. Are you getting an F in your health? Are you getting a D or a C? Well, that's going to be based on the way your body is functioning, which is called your physiology. And I want you to know that chiropractors are experts in the field of physiology, looking at how the body's functioning, because we are doctors of cause, not doctors of effect. Effects are symptoms. You can go to a doctor, he's going to look at the effects or the symptoms and more than likely going to put you on a medication. But you have to ask yourself, why did I get that effect? Why did I get that high blood pressure? Why did I get that pain, right? Why did I get that stomach problem or that indigestion? You know, do you really have a lack of nexium in your system? That's why you got indigestion? No, the likelihood is that you have some functional problem in your stomach that's creating your indigestion. And so chiropractors are doctors of cause, we're not doctors of effects. And in this country, we need doctors of cause. We need somebody who's going to look under the hood and really take a look at why are we getting sick in the first place. And usually that's going to come down to our lifestyle. The way that we're living our life has everything to do with the way that our body functions. There's three areas of your life, if you ask yourself, why am I getting sick or why am I healthy? There's three areas that you really need to focus on. The first one is how you're moving. And when I say how you're moving, I'm talking about your posture. I'm talking about, have you had any bad traumas, broken bones, sprains, strains? I'm talking about your most predominant posture during the day. Do you sit all day long? Or are you doing something repetitively that's creating a stress or strain on the body? So how you move has a lot to do with your health. The fact that you're exercising or you're not exercising has a lot to do with your physiology. We know without a doubt that when a person is exercising, they're using their joints, their muscles, but we're also using our brain. Think about it. We don't plug ourselves into the outlet at night to recharge our brain's battery, our brain. We have to move our body to generate electricity that powers our brain. So movement is an absolute necessity of life. Let's move on to the second thing that impacts our physiology or function, and that's our thoughts. We don't think about what we think about, we just think. And so stop and take time to think about what you're thinking about. You know, we have about 60,000 thoughts a day, and if you were to put a label on every single thought, would it be good? Would it be bad? Would it be positive? Would it be negative? Would it be upbeat and optimistic? Would it be depressive? And I guarantee you, if you were to put labels on all those 60,000 thoughts and add them up, your thoughts are reflective of how you are physiologically, how you feel. If you're an upbeat person, it's because you have upbeat thoughts. If you're a depressed person, it's probably because you have depressed thoughts. What comes first, the chicken or the egg? Well, I believe that the thinking, and who has control over your thoughts? You do, right? You get to choose your thoughts, or you can let them be chosen for you. So start thinking about managing stress, being optimistic, stop worrying, stop having so much grief. Start looking at, why am I blessed in my life? What is it that I'm thankful for, blissful for? What can I do to calm my mind? Start taking deep breaths, maybe look into meditation. You know, your thoughts are the most important thing that you can have ownership over every single day. Don't let them be influenced by other people. Take charge of your own thoughts. And then let's talk about the third and probably the most important thing, and that's what you're putting into your mouth. Okay, what are you putting into your mouth? And ask yourself, is this healthy? Is it going to give me energy or is it going to rob me energy? Your nutrition and your biochemical health is one of the most important things that you can be proactive with. Everything you put into your mouth has an impact. So it's either going to create health or it's going to create distress. And when you add these things up, right, some of the addictions that people have to sugar and cigarettes and alcohol and prescription medication, this biochemical stress, it's amazing that we can even stay healthy with all this barrage of biochemical toxins in our body. And when you add that to the stressful thoughts and the negative toxic thoughts and then the toxic movements, which is a lot of times not moving at all, it's no wonder why we're 37th in the world in terms of the healthcare of our citizens. So start thinking about being more proactive with the way that you eat, with the way that you think, and with the way that you move your body. It's the one thing I love about chiropractors is they're specialists in functional medicine or functional lifestyle. So I commend you on being in an office where the doctor is looking at cause, you know, looking at the nervous system, looking at the way the body is functioning, rather than just treating you for your symptoms. I can guarantee you one thing. You didn't get up this morning and brush your teeth because they hurt. You didn't get up this morning and take a shower because you don't want to smell, right? You got up and brushed your teeth and took a shower because you want your body to be as clean as possible. Not because you have symptoms, because you don't want to have symptoms, right? Like bad breath or to smell. It's no different with your health. You know, start making regular deposits, not when you're sick. Start making them long before you get sick so that you never get sick in the first place.